Hello folks, Robert from Marine Depot here, and thanks for tuning in. I'm sure most of you are familiar with cycling an aquarium. Now, if not, we have some really great videos on the topic, and you can check out the links in the video description below to learn more. Cycling your aquarium is so crucial because it allows time for beneficial bacteria to grow in your aquarium and establish your biological filtration. Now, in this video, we're going to discuss biological filtration and provide you with the necessary information to ensure you're providing the right environment for beneficial bacteria to thrive in your tank. The term biological filtration refers to the various beneficial bacteria that grows on just about every surface submerged in your aquarium. This bacteria breaks down and processes waste into less harmful byproducts, essentially filtering your aquarium water. So how does one go about providing biological filtration? Well, it's quite easy because nature does the work for you. Naturally, beneficial bacteria will grow on just about any submerged surface in your aquarium. This includes your rocks, your sand, biological filtration, your tank walls, your pumps, your heaters, and other equipment. For fish-only systems and freshwater aquariums, the use of bioballs, a wet-dry filter, or other biological filter media provide extra surface area for bacteria to grow. Boosting the bacteria population means waste is processed more effectively, in turn creating a healthier environment for your fish. When keeping a reef tank, the use of biological filter media is generally not recommended because this type of media is so effective at trapping and processing waste, and if it's not cleaned regularly, it can be very difficult to control your nitrate levels. Elevated nitrate levels in your reef tank can lead to some serious problems for your corals and invertebrates, as well as contribute to nuisance algae outbreaks. Thankfully, with the use of live rock for biological filtration in a reef tank, we can control waste and help avoid elevated nitrate levels. Live rock will host a variety of different bacteria both on the surface as well as deep within the pores of the rock. Aerobic bacteria growing on the outer surfaces that are exposed to fresh, oxygenated water will break down nitrate and ammonia. The denitrifying bacteria living deep within the rock, called anaerobic bacteria, will break down nitrate. This is why live rock is such an effective biological filter media. It will help to process and filter out all three byproducts of the nitrogen cycle: ammonia, nitrite, and nitrate. So what if you wanted to use dry rock in your aquarium instead of live rock? Can you get the same result? And the short answer is yes. It will simply take more time for beneficial bacteria to grow and colonize on dry rock when compared to live rock. Using a bacterial supplement such as Brightwell Microbacter 7 can help seed the dry rock to get the process moving along quicker. Regular addition of the bacterial supplement will help to maintain a diverse and healthy population of bacteria. Your sand bed is also another crucial environment for bacteria to grow because of the amazing amount of surface area that sand provides. The use of a shallow sand bed will provide a great environment for aerobic bacteria to process nitrite and ammonia. If you choose to run a deep sand bed that's more than 2 to 3 inches deep, you will effectively grow anaerobic bacteria as well to help control nitrate. Now, the same case applies when using dry sand versus live sand. Both have the capability to host bacteria, but live sand comes with bacteria already colonized, while dry sand will simply take a bit longer to establish in your tank. One key fact to remember about the bacteria that processes waste in your aquarium is that most of them are adhered to surfaces in your aquarium and they're not free floating. Now, this means that doing a water change will not affect the biological filtration in an established aquarium when done properly. The correct application of biological filtration in your aquarium, along with the use of various other filtration methods, will keep your water pristine and help to keep your corals, invertebrates, and fish happy and healthy. If you found our video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to help us spread the word. And until next time, take care and happy reef keeping.